Hey, and welcome. As you start to write code, you'll want a safe place to store it, track your changes, and build up your portfolio. GitHub is a great choice for all of these tasks. This course provides a gentle introduction to GitHub and GitHub Pages. I'm Deborah Kurata, and I'll be your guide through these useful tools.
This course is for anyone new to GitHub or GitHub Pages, or existing users that want to expand their GitHub knowledge. It's also useful for those that manage or interact with developers to better understand what these tools are and how they are used. Our tour includes a gentle introduction to Git, GitHub, and GitHub Desktop for storing our code, tracking our code changes, and optionally sharing our files. Many companies use GitHub to manage their software projects, and designers and developers use GitHub to show off their portfolio. We can use Git and access GitHub directly from within our code editor. We try out the Git integration in Visual Studio Code, also called VS Code. VS Code is a popular code editor that runs on all platforms. And we walk through how to use GitHub Pages to host a website. Each of these tools have many features. In this course, we'll focus on a subset of those features to accomplish common code management tasks. We'll cover how to set up a place to store your code on your computer, commit or save changes you make to those files to track your revisions, push or copy files to the GitHub website for storage somewhere other than your computer. This helps you manage your files, access them from multiple devices, and optionally share them with others. You'll see how to pull your files or anyone else's public files from GitHub and use GitHub Pages to host your website on GitHub so anyone on the internet can access your website. We'll use GitHub Desktop and VS Code to achieve these goals, which means we won't learn any Git command line syntax in this course. Here's the itinerary for our tour. We'll first introduce Git and GitHub. We define what a repository is. We walk through how to create and work with a repository. We try out GitHub Desktop and VS Code Git integration to interact with our repositories, and learn how to create and merge branches, which includes creating a pull request, or PR. We then publish a website with GitHub Pages. There aren't any prerequisites for our introduction to GitHub. When we later publish a website with GitHub Pages, the course assumes you understand basic web concepts and have a working knowledge of HTML. If you are new to web development, consider watching the Gentle Introduction to HTML for Beginners before watching the lesson on GitHub Pages. You can watch the demonstrations in this course, but if you'd prefer to try it with me as we tour the features of these tools, you'll want a computer, not a phone or tablet, and it's assumed you know how to install applications on that computer. And you'll need a browser, such as Chrome, Edge, or Safari. Everything else you need will install as we go. Trying it along with me is optional. Feel free to sit back and soak in the content. Settle in, and let's get started.